Hello everyone, after watching the making of Endoparasitic, I got intrigued by the unique gun system it has, so naturally I will show you how to recreate it. In this game, you reload the guns manually, one bullet at a time, instead of pressing a button and reloading automatically. And after that, you need to remove the bullets you used from the gun to load in new ones. This is what we're going to be making today. So here in our starting scene, I picked up a 3D revolver model from the asset store. And I also have a bullet image on the bottom left. It doesn't matter if your game is in 3D or 2D, this will work either way. First thing we have to do is to make the bullet image draggable. To do that, we will add a new script under the bullet image called bullet drag. In our script, we will use the event systems library. So next to mono behavior, we will add the iDrag handler. And we will make a new function called onDrag. Before we add anything in this function, we will need two things. A reference to the canvas and a reference to the rect transform of the object. Quick note, to make the canvas reference work, we will need to make a new tag in the inspector called canvas and add it to the canvas object. Now back in our script, we will modify the anchored position of the rect transform by increasing it by the event data.delta, which is the amount that the mouse moved from the previous frame, divided by the canvas.scale factor, which ensures that our movement will be the same despite the canvas scale. Now we can see that we can drag our bullets wherever we want, but we can't actually load the bullets in yet, we need to create the bullet slot functionality. To do that, we need to create 6 images and assign them over the gun chambers. Now on the first image, we'll create a new script called slot. In this script, we'll use the event systems library again, but this time, we'll use the onDrop function, which triggers whenever an object is dropped on the image. So we'll check if an object is dropped on the slot, and then destroy it. If we try this now, we can see that dropping the bullet on any chamber destroys it, but we still need to fill the chamber with a bullet. For that, we will create a new script on the gun object called gunManager. In this script, we will make 2 new arrays, one for the bullet objects, which are basically the bullets in the chambers, which are currently deactivated, and one boolean array to check whether or not a chamber is filled. Now we can create a new function in the gun manager to fill the slots. This function will take an index, which will basically be the number of the slot, and then it will loop 6 times, and if the I is equal to the index, then we will load the bullet to the corresponding slot. And in the slot script, we can now create a new int and a reference to the gun manager so that we can call the fill slot function when a bullet is dropped if the slot is not already filled. One quick thing before we are done with the loading system, we need to go back to the bullet drag script and add the iBeginDragHandle and iEndDragHandle, as well as reference a canvas group which we will later add. This step is needed because the bullet image is currently blocking the function of the slots, so we want to set block raycast true on the bullets whenever we pick them up. Finally, in Unity, after assigning the bullets and the slot indexes, we finally have the loading system working. Next, we will simulate the gun firing so that we can remove the bullets and add new ones. To do that, in the gun manager script, we will create a new array of bulls called bullet shot to keep track of which chambers are fired, and a new int called current slot to check which chambers will be fired next. Now we will create a new function called shoot, and we will check if we have a bullet filled in the current slot and if that bullet is fired. If we have a bullet that is not fired, we will set the bullet shot to true, increase the current slot by 1, and we will reset the current slot if it reaches the end. If our condition is not true, then we will increase the current slot and reset it. Now we can just call the function in the update method. The bullets at this point are shot, but there is no way for the player to know that. So we can quickly create a new black material and apply it to the mesh renderers of the bullets that are shot by referencing them in an array. This step is completely optional, and it's just my way of giving feedback to the bullets. For example, in Endoparasitic, fired bullets have a small black dot in the middle to indicate that they are fired. You can choose whichever way you want to indicate that. With that said, after assigning everything, we can see that we can now fire our bullets. And finally, we can now make the function to remove the fired bullets from the gun. So, back to the slot script, we will add the iPointerDown handler, and we will make a reference to a color to keep track of the starting color. Now, in the onPointerDown function, we will check if the chamber is filled and fired. Then, if we click on the fired bullet, we will reset the color and empty the chamber. And with that, we have all the main systems working. After that, feel free to add sound effects, particles, and whatever you see fit to make it look and feel better. That's all for now, until next time.